told you about living in the U.S. of A. Don't you know that I'm a gangster of love? Let me tell you people that I found a new way, and I'm tired of all this talk about love. And the same old story with a new set of words about the good and the bad and the poor. And the times keep on changing, so I'm keeping on top of every fat cat who walks through my door. I'm a space cowboy, bet you weren't ready for that. I'm a space cowboy, I'm sure you know where it's at. Yeah, 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 yeah. Rock, and I've been traveling through space since the moment I first realized what all you fast-talking cats would do if you could. You know I'm ready for the final surprise. There ain't no way around it, ain't nothing to say that's gonna satisfy my soul deep inside. All the prayers and surveyors keep the
Well, well, well. Whoa, 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 whoa. Put on the brakes, put on the brakes. Welcome, welcome, boys and girls, children of all ages, hoofties, puffties, bung-eyed heifers, right and left wing wackos, woodchucks, and chuckettes, kings and queens of the Northeast Kingdom, to and little dogs too, to another version of It's News to Us. And okay, little dog.
Mac looks like, I don't know if he thinks he knows where he is or not.
Oh, he doesn't care, as long as he's warm and someone feeds him. Don't worry.
He likes someone to scratch him, too.
Yeah. You just got to do the dirty next spring, that's all. And you're watching It's News to Us. We're Newport Georgia's TV news. Well, according to the governor, we're fake news. Now I'm getting to be, I really hear like an echo.
Okay, I'll take care of that.
According to the governor, we are fake news. We're Newport's oldest TV news watch now. And we had adult themes and adult language, but not really. I mean, come on. We don't do any cussing or anything like we used to. And we're all inclusive here. We cater to men, women, use any bathroom you want. We don't care. We're the Bronze Age Invisible Sky God. You're going to beat you and forgive you and beat you and forgive you. And defund the police? No, defend the police, okay? The days of the good cops covering up for the bad cops are over. And there's Dementia Joe, our new president. Get out of my house, you kids. Get off my lawn. We had a town hall meeting yesterday. My God, the gibberish. He was wandering. It's no wonder they're having the vice president talk to foreign leaders. And here we attack ideas, not people. I mean, come on. And speaking of which, the question that got me booted from the governor's news conferences was when I asked about the Elizabeth Warren high cheekbone standard for Abenakis. Now, I would have thought that the governor, being in the state house when all this was going on, and this was pretty controversial. You remember Philo, right?
Yeah, vaguely, yeah.
Yeah, because we had Howard next door.
Oh, my gosh, don't start that.
Yeah. He's not a real Indian. I'll tell you who's a real Indian. Oh, man, Howard. Howard's a unit.
I will bet you he's not a unit anymore.
Yeah. And there was a lot of opposition to this because there were people who, you know, who thought that the bill would give them, recognition, state recognition or whatever, would allow casinos and all this other stuff. And so, you know, I mean, you would think that they would know what would governor with old pickle nose being in the Senate at the time. He's now governor. Excuse me, Governor Pickle Nose. That he would remember, you know, that there is a way to gain tribal recognition. And as a matter of fact, I have here, the studio was nice enough to print it up. It's called AbenakiTribe.org, okay? And here is enrollment information and form where you can seek to camera 2, Philo.
Hold on.
Thanks.
I got a hiccup here. Hold on.
And you can seek to qualify and become a tribal member. And this is what I asked the governor about. And as usual, because I caught them flat-footed, they didn't have a response because, you know what, they don't do their homework. I found that out with Black Lives Matter. When they thought, oh, Black Lives Matter, it's just a wonderful, you know, it sounds great, it's a good slogan. Well, it's not just a good slogan, it's a what do you call it? It's a subsidiary of 1,000 Currents. And 1,000 Currents is this outfit run by one Susan Rosenberg, who was pardoned by Bill Clinton. She was doing federal time for possession of explosives and stuff from the 1970s. I guess she was a member of, like, I don't know, well, if it was SDS or the Weathermen or some damn thing. And there's Ike, man. This is the first time I ever saw my dad tear up, Philo.
Really?
It was when Ike was giving his farewell address, and he came on and he warned us. He warned us about it. I'm reading a book about that right now, about the U2 being shot down, called Mayday. And Ike had problems. He warned us about the military-industrial spying intelligence complex, and even Harry Truman. Harry Truman thought that he would make one agency to gather all this spying information, have them report directly to the president, and call it the Central Intelligence Agency, and then it would you could eliminate the BS. Well, oh, mister, didn't that create more BS? But anyways,
it usually does, doesn't it?
Yeah. It make the government bigger and bigger and bigger.
I'd like to know how he does that. How does he lay on his side? His ears go straight out.
He's got bat ears, man.
Good heavens!
Like a Doberman. So, anyways, they have there's an enrollment form, and there's actually a woman up here in the North Country who does genealogical traces. And you'd think the governor would have known this, but no, they didn't know that. And what it did was, when I mentioned Elizabeth Warren, who evidently is a goddess to the governor's press secretary there, Rebecca Kelly, she's a goddess, you know. Elizabeth Warren is one of her goddesses, so I get accused of racism. All right. Now, for any of you, all three of you out there who've been watching this show for a long time, no, we don't do racism here. As a matter of fact, I actually had to tell somebody last summer if they used the N-word again in my house, they wouldn't be welcome in my house anymore.
I remember that.
Yeah, there you go.
You told me about that person.
And that's the way it is, because that was like, no, you just don't go there. And but anyways, here is a... my decision, my appeal. They said that for months we simply took your word as fact that I'm hobby entertainment, not journalism. So every week I come in here on my own. The fact that I don't get paid for this, I guess makes me not a real journalist. It doesn't matter that for the past 9.5 months. And luckily, Philo, I kept a journal. I took a pad of paper, right?
Yeah.
And I wrote down every week. I'd have questions from viewers, questions from people who emailed the studio. I had questions from people on the street. And I had all my sources, and I wrote down the websites where I got this stuff. So I've got a whole folder of stuff that I've been using for the past 9.5 months. But anyways, here's back to the denial. I'm hobby, yeah.
Well, you know, here was the thing, Steve. This is what got me. First, they said it was perceived racism. And then they shifted gears and they went over somewhere else.
Yeah.
So
isn't
they
that
would,
funny?
So this would tell you that they were just looking for a reason.
Yeah.
Exactly. See?
On Wednesday, 2 weeks ago, it went from perceived racist comments in action, and they evidently wanted Todd to spank me or something, take me out to the woodshed. and then the following day, it was because it was hobby entertainment. And the governor was on some AM news show, and one of the guys, some guy I know, got through. And he actually watched the show that we did, the hour-long interview with Pete Garitano about the PCR tests. And he said, he told the governor, he said, look, he's not a comedian, you know. Well, I never said I was. You know, sometimes the news is so absurd, it's funny. But, you know, that's neither here nor there.
And we might crack a joke on occasion.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, Philo's got the puns, man. not always good ones either.
Oh, heavens, they're never good.
Please know, this decision was made with much consideration, deliberation, and reflection, and with great respect and appreciation for the role of a free press and journalism in our republic. In our republic, the Republic of Vermont? I thought this was a state issue. What are we? Is it 1777 again, Philo?
I think it could be. I think somebody went into the Wayback Machine, you know?
Yeah.
Mr. Sherman. Peabody.
Peabody and Sherman, exactly. As you observed in your appeal, for months we took your word. Generally speaking, it's best left to journalists to define what is and is not journalism. In this regard, I agree with your assertion that government should avoid doing this with the greatest extent possible. However, after complaints and objections, which they never note, Philo, I guess I'm going to have to do an open records request.
Now, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Hey, I want to get in on this one.
I'm going to have to do an open records request to find out how many there were and what they were specifically. A review of your show led executive office staff to conclude that it is, at best, entertainment, not news. At that point, in the absence of clearly defined standards or principles that could be applied to the profession itself, the staff felt it had an obligation to draw a line. The staff being Rebecca, okay, who got a bee in her bonnet and has had one for quite some time.
I might have put it in another way. You know, Steve, you're far more polite than I am.
Well, we try to be. I have to be polite, especially on those call-in conferences, or I would have got the boot 8 months ago. But no, only after 9.5 months, I started asking questions that they did. I've been asking questions that they don't like. You know, stuff like the Danish mass study that proved that masks don't really work. And we'll get to that. More on that later. Hopefully
what I'm
we'll
curious
have time.
About, though, Steve, and it's too bad you didn't. I was going to have you ask this question. Now that Fauci wants everyone to wear two masks, if they were going to follow suit and have Vermont mandate that now.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's always about power. That's all it's about. It's about raw power. And he had just extended the emergency again, which is unnecessary because he can do everything, the vaccine distribution and, you know, the setting up emergency hospitals if need be, which the governor mumbles over in New York is in trouble for.
Oh, good, good. I don't like him either.
Oh, man, is he? They underestimated the death count. They didn't count the people who died in hospitals, even though they were sent there from nursing homes, and then they were sent back to the nursing homes to spread COVID around, even though he had three different places where he could have sent them. One, the hospital ship that Trump sent up, which was had its air circulation thing completely changed for antiviral. Two, the Jacob Javits Center, again, which they had converted into beds and everything else and changed the air circulation. And three, a mobile hospital set up in Central Park by the Samaritan's Purse, the Christian people. So he had three different places where he could have sent all these seniors. But no, he decides to send them from the hospitals back to the nursing homes with a infected other staff and patients. He's gonna, and then he goes on and he gets an Emmy for his press conferences, and he writes a book on leadership. Well, I'll tell you what, mister. And of course, he indemnifies himself and the city and everybody else from lawsuits, Philo. So he's in trouble. But anyways, let's see. The rest of the feedback, here we are. In making this determination, the executive office sought and received formal and informal input from journalists, the associations that represent them, other public access stations, and everyday Vermonters. In one case, a Vermonter reached out to express support for reinstating your credentials. The rest of the feedbacks supported the initial decision to yank them. A particular note: while one professional association chose to remain neutral, another wrote to express its support for the decision. That wouldn't be the liberal snowflake Vermont Press Association, would it, Philo?
Well, from what I have heard, and this is just what I have heard, and I would like to get some verification if you could find this. The people that were there, the press people, may not have liked you, but they did not think you should have been yanked.
A few of them, yes. Yes.
Well,
true.
The majority of them. And the van people all supported you.
Yeah. And, of course, they came out and denounced racism. Well, I mean, who couldn't denounce racism? We've been doing that for 60 years now.
That's another thing they're going to drag out forever, too.
Oh, man. We'll get to that.
Yep.
So, anyways, their concern centered on the potential for your participation to undermine confidence in bona fide broadcast journalism. So my mere presence, Philo, could undermine confidence in journalism.
Well, I don't know. You've been pretty communist all these years, just like me.
Yes, comrade. And I've spent the past 4 years, because of Trump and his Russian aides, I've spent the past 4 years watching for the Russians behind woodpile, and all I found out there were empty storage Naya bottles and unfiltered cigarette butts.
Huh. Well, I'll tell you one thing. If you and I had anything to do with that, we'd be a lot richer than what we are.
Yeah, they interfered with the election. That one's still going on. And it took them, 2-3 weeks? To come out and finally retract the story that the guy at the Capitol was not beaten to death with a fire extinguisher like they said he was? Huh. Why would they and cremate him right away? Why would they do that? No autopsy or nothing, Philo?
I still haven't gotten over the 9/11 attacks.
Oh, man.
Everybody knew about. Everybody knew was coming.
Oh, yeah, our vaunted intelligence agencies. Oh, which they did one good thing, Philo. Did you notice that we haven't heard anything about the WHO and their coronavirus search over in China, right?
Right.
Well, they had that Peter Daszak guy on there, which we told you about weeks ago, who had an insane conflict of interest because he supported the Bat Lady and everything. Well, I guess the intelligence agencies told them to pipe down, because then they told the president and his, the inner circle, that they knew better, okay? Because the old people, Trump's people, were hinting that, the intelligence people knew this stuff and they could declassify it, but they're worried about sources and methods because they got a lot of spies in China, just like China's got a lot of spies over here,
yeah.
Right? And anyways, speaking of racism, for years and years, we've been telling you about Brother Fred Hampton, okay, who the FBI, along with the Chicago Police Department, killed in 1969, okay? But anyways, it looks like finally there's a movie about Brother Fred, and it's called Black Messiah, and I can't wait for it to come out. I hope it comes out on DVD or so. Have to have you guys ask you guys if there's a way to stream it and put it on DVD. But anyways, in the early hours, and this is from Tuesday's paper, yesterday, the 16th, in the early hours of December 4th, 1969, Chicago police, they never mentioned the FBI except for the informant later on, raided Illinois Black Panther Party chairman Fred Hampton's home and shot him to death. He was 21. More than 50 years later, director Shaka King's Judas and the Black Messiah in theaters and streaming on HBO Max is bringing Hampton's story to the big screen, and along with the FBI informant, William O'Neill. He was the one who they drugged Fred. Because Fred was no junkie, and they found all kinds of, they say fentanyl here, but I don't think fentanyl was around in 69, Philo.
No, it was not. That came out in the early 2000s.
Well, they had the patches in the mid-90s.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, I think so.
I can look it up if you want to give me a chance.
It don't matter. I thought it was heroin. This whatever. They gave him the FBI informant made sure that he was drugged, so that he couldn't shoot back. And you should see the pictures. You can find them on the net if you look hard enough. The pictures of the crime scene where they went in there and just shot the place up. I mean, it looks like it looks like one of those things from Elliot Ness and the Untouchables with the Tommy guns, Philo.
I remember that.
Oh, it's insane. Though King says it was hard to get things 100% factual because of the FBI's unreliable record keeping. Oh, you mean their unreliable record keeping. This is the same FBI that allowed Whitey Bulger to kill people down in Boston. The same FBI that had this Russian conspiracy thing on Trump that petered out and turned out to be a fart in the wind for 4 years. This is the same FBI that's had Hunter Biden's laptop for the past, there's your Italian Carcano rifle. The same FBI that had Hunter's laptop for a year ago December and could have stopped the first impeachment just by bringing out the fact that Hunter's dirty and he doesn't have IRS problems. He has money laundering problems, and they're big time. And I hope that Congress flips and they start to, in 2 years, the Congress flips and they have to do a real investigation because they only scratch the surface. There's an 82-page report from the Senate about Hunter's dirty dealings. You can find it on the web. It was from last summer. But anyways, all of this stuff could have come out before the election, but then they stopped it. And big tech stopped it too. Big tech, those fascist pukes, put a bite on the Twitter account where you could go to get the story. Oh, that's not censorship, Philo. Hell no. In the summer of 69, the police engaged in a shootout with the Panther members, which culminated in the arrests of several people and cops burning the building down, just like in Philadelphia with the MOVE people in the 80s, remember?
Yep.
Shows that the police were always trying to provoke the Panthers. They don't know the specifics about what it started, but the police claimed there was a sniper on the roof. Of course there was. There was a guard with a rifle on the roof because these guys weren't paranoid. Now, and here's the biggest thing about Brother Fred Hampton. And let's see. If he had been conscious, he could have defended himself. But the thing is, the big thing is that Brother Fred was dangerous, not because he was a Black Panther. Brother Fred was dangerous because he said, look, it's not about Black power. It's not about brown power. It's not about white power. It's about all of us getting together because we're being we're all getting stepped on by a few rich people who run the show, and you know, And this was back when wages were still going up with productivity, which stopped as soon as Reagan got elected.
That's right. I remember that.
Productivity kept going up and up, and wages went down, down, down. So now we've got a permanent underclass, which, by the way, the last thing they want is a permanent underclass that is well-armed, okay? So look for the gun bills to be coming shortly.
I got arms right here. Yeah. Got two arms.
But as you know, they lied incessantly. He's convinced it was O'Neill's doing, the snitch, adding that Hampton would have died from the fentanyl even if police hadn't killed him. Oh, please. If he'd been conscious, then he could have defended himself. Let's see. And where's the other thing? There was another. Here it is. The 10 best movies at Sundance. And here's the deal right here.
I get that on my Roku.
Cool. Fred Hampton, the Black Panther Party chairman, whose goal is to form a rainbow coalition of disenfranchised people. And he was especially great as an orator and a complex leader deemed too dangerous to exist by the federal government. And that's it in a nutshell. Brother Fred didn't care what color, like the rest of us, like all of us, Fred Hampton didn't care what color you were. It was irrelevant, okay? It didn't matter. We're all living in a free country. We're all free to sleep under a bridge if we get sick and lose our job and get broke. And here we are. Look at this is from Thursday's paper, and they're still repeating the big lie. And they wonder why it's fake news. And they say, oh, my version of the news is slanted, Philo. Really? Really? Listen to this. Thanks. Five people died, including a police officer hit with a fire extinguisher and a woman shot by an officer, which we still don't know his name. I wonder why. And you can see that video by Jaden X. That's the guy. Oh, man. His name is Sullivan. And he's a black kid. He runs an outfit called Insurgents USA. And he broke in there, and he's under FBI investigation and indictment also. And I asked Phil Scott about that. Oh, boy, that's probably had the racist overtones, Philo. The fact that I mentioned that one of the people that was conspired to do this riot happened to be a black kid who runs an outfit called Insurgents USA. I mentioned that at Scott's press conference, so that must make me racist, right, Philo?
Hey, I can dig it.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Yeah, they could say to anyone they got their hands on would have been killed. They were talking about assassinating the Vice President of the United States. Oh, really? Well, you know, I happen to have something right here that I saved from last week or the week before about assassination. They were talking about assassinating the Vice President. Well, look at this one, Philo. And this is from January 16th. This was from right afterwards. But look at this. Feds walk back assassination plans or details. Huh. So it's like, and people wonder why it's fake news, okay? Walk back claims of assassination plans. Well, 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 isn't that something? 1 week there's an assassination plan, next week there isn't. And here we are. This is from today's paper, I believe. Get ready, Philo. Yeah, this is from, it's from Thursday's. And, of course, Dr. Levine had mentioned in the press conference that, you know, they did a study and they found that two masks work better than one. Yeah, well, dumbasses. Here's what it says right here.
I thought that was Fauci that started that.
Yeah, right here. But Levine agreed with it.
Oh, jeez.
CDC study. Two masks are better than one. Now, get this. Now, it's not peer-reviewed, okay? It's not a double-blind study where they actually had infected people and to see if anybody got infected. You know, it's not a real study. The CDC reported the results of a lab experiment. So now it's gone from a study in the headline to a lab experiment in the article, Philo, that spaced two artificial heads 6 feet apart to check to see how many virus-sized particles spewed by one were inhaled by the other. The researchers found that wearing one mask, surgical or cloth, blocked about 40% of the particles to the head that was breathing in. When a cloth mask was worn on top of the surgical mask, about 80% were blocked. Yeah.
And if you made it out of Kevlar, you wouldn't be able to breathe, would you?
Exactly. Brooks said, yeah, get this, CDC's Dr. John Brooks. Brooks said agency officials heard about people wearing two masks and wanted to evaluate the benefit. It's got nothing to do with Fauci coming out and putting his foot in his mouth, mister. Oh, hell no.
Of course it does.
This study had many limitations. The researchers used one brand of surgical mask and one kind of cloth mask, and it's not clear if the results would be the same with every product. But it echoes some earlier research that suggests two masks are better than one. Huh. It suggests that, Philo.
And do you like breathing your own carbon dioxide? Is that healthy for you, boys and girls?
Oh, sure. There's absolutely no problem with wearing masks. Never mind that Danis mask study. You can look that up online. If it's still there, it's probably been scrubbed. But you pay no attention to the science we don't believe is science.
Well, here's the problem, Steve. Everybody's convoluting the science so bad that you really don't know what's right anymore.
They're politicizing it.
Everybody's got their own agenda and their own spin on it. I mean, really, when you think about it, it's gotten really bad.
The CDC, it works, Brooks said. The CDC updated its guidance, saying that you can wear a cloth mask on top of a disposable surgical mask for better fit and extra protection. If done correctly, the combination can tighten the gaps around the edges that could let particles in. The agency also said that it will remove a make-your-own mask page, which went up last year when they were in short supply. Oh, we're gonna remove that page and put up this one because the science just isn't there anymore. The science is constantly evolving, Philo. This is one thing we keep hearing, right?
On a daily basis, though? For gosh sakes. That's what they're doing. They're making it up as they go every day. Heck, they should get together with Sean Hannity. He does the same thing.
And here's the fear. Here we go with the fear. Some Americans have already started doubling up. Experts believe that's at least partly out of concern about the new strains that have been found to spread more easily. Doesn't mention the fact that the strains might be less dangerous or less lethal. Oh, no, that's Mueller's ratchet. We don't want you to look that up either. Let's see, I found a spread more easily. And then here, this gets to this sentence, one sentence gets its own paragraph, Philo. CDC guidance has evolved, period. Wow, science has evolved. It's evolved. Huh, so we don't live on a flat earth anymore?
Looks flat to me.
Oh, good grief. Yeah, I've been to the edge, man. I'm telling you, it's right off the beach in San Diego.
I know. Isn't that? That's amazing. It's just amazing.
Oh, my God. Oh, jeez. When it began, the Surgeon General said, stop buying masks, wrote in a tweet almost a year ago. 2 months later, after it became clear that infected people who did not exhibit symptoms could spread the virus, the CDC recommended masks. Well, it's still not clear if people who have it, who are asymptomatic can spread it. They're still unclear on that.
Oh, but they're claiming it. They're claiming if you're asymptomatic, you can still spread it. Oh boy, you can still spread it.
Yep. Oh, here we are again. Discussions. We got to hold a conversation about this, Philo. Discussions.
I'd rather have a yelling match.
Yeah, discussions about double masking and higher quality masks are important, said Dr. Isaac Bogoch, an infectious disease scientist at the University of Toronto. So discussions are important.
Here's what these snowflakes don't understand, Steve. They can trot out 50 doctors that say mask or double mask, and I will find you 50 that say they don't work.
And they mention absolutely nothing about, and we've known this for years and years, that the soils that we grow our food in are being depleted of minerals and micronutrients.
That's right.
And that simply by taking, zinc supplements, you don't have to take big ones, and vitamin D, especially this time of year when it's cloudy all the time, and don't get me going about the windmills and solar panels in Texas. We had a lot of people with a lot of pop pipes, man. I'm thinking of setting up a plumbing company and going to Texas, Philo.
Well, didn't they have their own independent power grid?
And yeah, they do.
Failed miserably.
Yeah. They were listening to the science. We got to get rid of the CO2. Even if it means knocking out the base load from under your feet. Now, here's what I don't get. We got windmills in Sheffield where it's like 30 below, right?
Yeah.
And the worst weather on the planet.
Yeah.
We got windmills in Lowell, which is lower in elevation, but has some pretty nasty weather.
Yes, the second worst weather.
And they seem to work okay. What happened to the ones in Texas? Were they like the B-grade ones?
Who knows?
In good grief. And this is from today's paper here. Experts fear fourth wave of renewed virus. See, remember, we got to keep this fear going, or we'll lose control. Oh, and I got to get to that article. Oh, and here's another thing, too. Denise King died, and her maiden name was Laramie. She grew up in North Troy. And to all the Laramie brothers and sisters out there, I think they're mostly brothers, and my buddy Moose especially, our condolences. She was the oldest of like seven kids, and they grew up right on Railroad Street in North Troy. And if she's anything like the rest of the kids, like the rest of them, she must have been a real nice person. Remember I told you about these two, they're going to spank Florida because, see, they don't want any free states. They don't want any people having fun, not wearing masks, going out and eating and having, doing stuff like that, because that would ruin their whole narrative, Philo, right? So what do we got to do? Thank you. We got to spank Florida, right? So what do? They have this whole article about this lesbian couple who have to travel all the way across the state to get their second shot. And it turns out that they were too stupid to wait or something and get the shot nearby. So they figured, I gotta get the shot now. And the only place they could get one like right away was they live in Miami-Dade or something. So they had to go all the way up to near Tallahassee, near like Alabama. And so now they find out you have to get your second shot where you got your first shot. So now they got to figure out how to travel there again. Get this. Desperate to be protected from the deadly virus, Eileen Kovlock and her wife, Kay Brannigan, drove nearly 600 miles to the panhandle to get vaccinated. Now, with their second shot scheduled in 2 weeks, the couple from Lake Worth Beach in Southeast Florida is dreading having to make the same 1,200-mile, 18-hour round-trip journey again. Well, how about the blue states that are having the lockdown states that are having problems with the vaccine rollouts, Philo?
You mean like Vermont?
Vermont, yeah, it's not as bad as some of the other states from what I hear.
Well, I'll tell you, as of yesterday, my wife, who is 72, can get the vaccine, but I can't. I'm about 3 months short of being 70.
Oh, good grief.
However, I was told that because I live in the same house as her, I could have. But since we're going to be vacationing, we're going to wait till we get back.
Unbelievable.
I don't believe it.
And here we are. Senate finds Trump not guilty of inciting a riot. Well, duh. I mean, If you looked at anything and everything these other people have said, and you know what? Who it started with, Philo? It started with that proverbial genius, Maxine Waters, yelling at her supporters that if you see anyone from that cabinet or the administration at a gasoline station, at a restaurant, you get up in their faces or whatever, and you tell them they're not welcome. I mean, that's not a way America works. I mean, you can heckle politicians, sure. I mean, it's the world's oldest sport. You know, they used to call it the heckler's veto, you know. When you'd go to give a speech and some leather-lunged hillbilly would be out in the audience giving you a hard time. But that's why they came out with microphones and amplifiers, you know?
Exactly. I love those things.
And speaking of which, Jerry Ford once came to Concord, Mass to give a speech on the 200th anniversary of the shoot-down at Concord and Lexington, and he got up on stage, and some wise asses that I happened to be with had planted M-80s up on the hills surrounding the Old North Bridge. And he gets up to give his speech, and next thing you know, it's like boom, boom, boom. And you remember the M-80s back in the 70s, Philo. They were the size of a half dollar.
Yeah, they were. We used to call them ash cans in New York.
Oh, dude, yeah. And so the Secret Service grabbed him and hustled him off. But if you go on Wikipedia and look up Jerry Ford, they've got a copy of the speech, but it doesn't say that he was sent away by...
Didn't Sarah Palin say that the Battle of Concord and Lexington was in Concord, New Hampshire?
No, that was Bachman.
Well, that was Bachman. I get him so confused. Those two were wing nuts anyway.
I'm so glad to be in Concord, New Hampshire, where, it's home of the Minutemen.
You mean Minute Maid.
Yeah. And I don't have much time left, so I'm not going to do the Young Whiners Project. As we got, you talk about being indoctrinated. Well, this is it, people. This is the end of public schools as we know them. Because your kids are getting politically indoctrinated, okay? At least they were neutral. When we were kids in elementary school, we had debating teams, and you had to pick a side. You had to flip a coin. And I got to – we had a debate on the Vietnam War. And guess who got the coin flip, and I had to defend the Vietnam War, Philo. Yours truly.
That wasn't good.
Oh, and speaking of nasty politics – this day in history right here, I'll take my word for it, it's here. There was a feud in 1798 on February 15th, a feud between two members of the House of Representatives boiled over as Roger Griswold of Connecticut, who was a Federalist, used a cane to attack Vermont's Matthew Lyon. who defended himself with a set of fireplace tongs. Griswold was enraged over the House refusal to expel Lyon for spitting tobacco juice in his face 2 weeks earlier. After the two men were separated, a motion to expel them both was defeated. And so you know what happened to old Matt Lyon, Philo?
What's that?
Well, according to the Alien and Sedition Act, which was passed by John Adams... when Jefferson was vice president, he made fun of President Adams, which the court found him guilty of sedition. So they took our only congressman and put him in a jail cell, an unheated jail cell in Vergennes, and there wasn't even glass in the window, just bars, Philo. So his friends had to get together and put in a window and a wood stove in the cell for our only congressman, or he would have froze to death. Yeah, and they say politics, Joe Biden's going to restore normalcy. What, are you kidding me? This has been going on forever. He got a prison sentence just for making fun of President Adams. He called him bald, toothless, and quarrelsome, as I recall.
Yeah, but what if you're telling the truth?
Yeah.
You shouldn't have to go to jail for telling the truth.
Yeah, that's well, it's, thanks to New York Times v. Sullivan, we can make fun of politicians. And not have to worry about it. Oh, here's a good one. This ring of people were
were stealing drugs from pharmacies down in Atlanta, Philo.
Yeah.
They arrested nearly a dozen people who believed to have been connected to a multiple pharmacy burglaries. And what they did was, they instead of those little, you know, packets that they have inside to keep the pills dry, you know,
yeah,
they substituted them with GPS units, Philo.
Wow.
On the controlled substances. After a tracking device and a pill bottle led them to a home in Northwest Atlanta. The arrests happened about 11:30 a.m., several hours after a break-in call, and the investigation was reportedly very active. Oh, Biden faces pressure on immigration. Oh, you think? We are seeing a mad rush at the border, and they're back again. And this is one of the things, you know, I don't care about Trump's nasty tweets and this and that, and him calling the press fake news. At least he didn't try and throw reporters in jail like Obama did. Obama brought one guy right up to the Supreme Court. What was his name? James Risen or Rosen, remember?
No, I don't, but you got it right, probably.
He went after reporters for, you know, publishing leaks, a classified, semi-classified information. But anyways, one thing that Trump knew is that here's the thing. Under Bush, the average wages of the people, you know, at the lower end of the scale went up like $1,000 or $1,200, right? Under Obama, it was about $1,200 to $1,500, right?
Yeah.
Under Trump, it was $6,000. And why was it $6,000? Because they stopped the flow of illegal immigrants coming in and taking away, working for nothing, basically. And that, and getting rid of some stupid regulations and crap like that, and bang, the economy went, you know, it was a simple formula. And, it was the first time in 20 years I've lived up here, I'd see help wanted signs all over the place. Everything free in America. Yeah, he's taken some major steps. He hasn't lifted some of the significant barriers. Let's see. It would slowly allow an estimated 25,000 people to enter the U.S. And you know what? Here's the thing. They're not even going after the damn... they're not even going after the... what do you call it? The criminals. And what happened to Mothers Against Drunk Driving? Remember, they got signs all over the place, Philo. DUI, you can't afford it, right?
Yeah, you don't see them now.
Oh, we don't. Well, they're still up there. There's one on the hill going up to Derby, right?
Oh, there is? Wow.
Yeah, near the Newport border.
I thought they replaced them all with the, you must quarantine if you're out of state. That's all I see on every exit on the interstate.
Well, now it's no big thing, according to Joe Biden. Hey, felony drunk driving, it's okay. No hobbling glass, we'll get you a lawyer and everything. Yeah, here's Governor Mumbles right here. Cuomo, what's the headline? Cuomo's team accused of cover-up. Oh, you think? Yeah, and he was outed by his own his own secretary. After she resigned, she said they froze over worries the information was going to be used against us. Oh, you think? Let's see. In recent weeks, New York was forced to acknowledge the nursing home death toll is nearly 15,000 when Cuomo said it was only 8,500, a number that excluded residents who died after being taken to hospitals. Oh, okay.
Max going now. Here he goes.
Grunty. Go, Grunty, go. So it looks like, sometimes justice takes a while, but it really does come around. Oh, Fauci wins $3 million prizes for defending science. Oh, and this is from... pandemic blame for increase in overdoses. Oh, you think? Well, they don't count, man. They're only junkies. You know, never mind that they're in their 20s and 30s and had their whole life ahead of them. You know, now, Fauci defending science. Dr. Fauchenstein, we've told you and I've showed you where you can go on the web and find out that Fauci
when they banned this type of research, this gain-of-function stuff, or weaponization, as I call it, when they banned it in the United States, Fauci paid to have it done overseas. Oh, because, you know, we do it. We got to keep it up. And here's one from this day in history. In 1778, during our revolution, the United States won official recognition and military support after signing the Treaty of Alliance in Paris from France. I'm telling you, we owe the French a debt of gratitude. Never mind the British. We were fighting them. We owe everything we are, we owe to the French. And damn it, and look what it got them, man. Old Louis lost his head along with Marie Antoinette, because they broke the treasury and started taxing the crap out of their own people. And here we are in 1933. The 20th Amendment to the Constitution, the so-called lame duck amendment, was proclaimed in effect by Secretary of State Henry Stimson. And what was the 20th Amendment, Philo?
I just know the 21st. I don't remember the 20th.
I think that's the booze one. I got the Constitution in my pocket.
The 21st is the prohibition.
Oh, okay.
Isn't it?
I don't know.
Hold on, I'll find it. I'll just Google it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got it, really.
You got it?
I will get it.
That quick, because I got the Constitution right here. Let's see who's faster, me or Philo.
20th Amendment.
What is the 20th Amendment?
The term of the vice president shall end at noon on the 20th day of January.
The United States Constitution moved the beginning and ending of the terms of the president and vice president from March 4th to January 20th, and of members of Congress from March 4th to January
3rd. That's all. I thought it was prohibition, but it wasn't. It's when it just changed inauguration day, for crying out loud.
What is the 21st Amendment?
No wonder it was the lame duck.
According to Britannica, 21st Amendment.
Yeah, the 21st was prohibition.
Yeah. Well, that's really why he won. And you know what? I'm proud to live in one of the only two states that didn't vote for FDR. There were only two states that didn't go for FDR. And one was Vermont and the other was Maine. And look at this. They're still rationing masks, Philo, even though they've got stockpiles of N95s at the factories. So what's up with that, man?
It's all a fake. The whole thing is just a scare. You can wear anything on your face, and as long as you're covering your nose and mouth, everybody's fine. But as soon as you take it off, they flip out.
Oh, yeah. AP spoke with a dozen procurement officers who buy supplies from more than 300 hospitals, said they all have enough N95s now, and between 2 and 12 months' worth sitting in storage. Huh. But, you know, it's... We're really short on everything, and you got to be scared. And here we are. See, this is it. The thing has changed. This is from Monday, February 15th. And China says, oh, no, the virus didn't start here, Philo. Oh, it came in on some frozen food from Australia.
Yeah, right.
Oh, sure. That's what they're saying. China fired back at the U.S. on Sunday over allegations from the White House that Peking withheld info about the outbreak from the WHO investigators. And National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan said Washington had deep concerns about the way in which the early findings of the investigation were communicated and questions about the process used to reach them. It's imperative that this report be independent with expert findings free from intervention or alteration by the Chinese government. So the WHO is saying, oh, no, the Chinese are just great people, and we got to believe everything it says. Butter wouldn't melt in their mouths, Philo. But yet the U.S. intelligence people are all like, look, we know differently, all right? We know differently, so shut the hell up, all right? Oh, man. Here we are. Biden order reestablishes the faith-focused White House office. Now, we've told you before, we make fun of organized religions here, especially ones that prey on children, discriminate against women, blow stuff up, stuff like that. But never anyone's faith. But anyways, listen to this, what he has to say, Philo. The White House said the office goals, including working to address the pandemic, boost economic recovery, combat systemic racism,
increase opportunity and mobility for historically disadvantaged communities, and strengthen pluralism. What? I thought we got over this. There is no systemic racism in this country.
As Ben Shapiro said recently, he said, it's not about equal opportunity. What they want is equal outcome.
It's a communist, Marxist trope, exactly.
And you can't have equal outcome because not everyone is the same.
Yeah.
Some people are talented in one direction or the other. But anyways.
Yeah, and if you don't pay attention and learn in school, you're going to be a dumbass, and you're going to be wind up being a dumbass all your life unless you begin to learn afterwards, you know?
Yep.
And it's your own fault half the time, because look, people aren't born stupid, even though you might think so with some people. It's... You know, and here we are, the Japanese have reached a 50% herd immunity with no vaccines, Philo.
Yep.
So finally now they're going to start stabbing people or vaccinating them in Japan. They have 50% herd immunity without locking anybody down. Unbelievable. What's missing from Vermont's Congress, Philo? From the congressional delegation?
Brains.
Diversity.
Oh, by the way, last but not least.
Yeah, that's it. You know, this is what happened with revolutions. They eventually eat their own. And I guess being Jewish ain't being part of a minority no more, Philo. If you're Jewish, you're just another old white guy.
Well, I guess so.
Unreal. Come on, man. Be part of the tribe. When I think of inclusion, the diamond merchant comes out in me, and I think of inclusions, which are flaws in diamonds.
Well, Matt, come here.
If Philo can make Italian jokes, I can make Jewish ones. Come on.
I can dig it.
Oh, once again, you wasted a perfectly good hour of your life watching this stupid show. So hopefully we'll see you again next week, inshallah. And until then, go down to the perfectly peaceful Methodist church where they plot and plan to blow stuff up and say, God is great, God is great, God is great. Whoa, Mackie.
And a final Deus Magnus Est, and I hope I haven't offended any Latin people.
It keeps on getting darker outside. Space cowboy, bet you weren't ready for that. I'm a space cowboy, I'm sure you know where it's at. Yeah, 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 story. It's the same old crime, and you've got some heavy dues to pay.
make a mistake, cowboy. Bet you weren't ready for that. A mistake, cowboy.